Now, this question says an amount changes from 1000 to 1331 rupees in 3 years. Find rate of compound interest. So in this case, it is already given compound interest compounded annually. Right? So here it is already given that it is compounded annually. That is important to be given because we need to know the number of periods, whether it is equal to number of years or not. So here P is given as 1000 rupees. A is given as 1331 rupees. R we have to calculate, right? And N is given as 3. Why? Because annual and 3 years. So N is straight away equal to 3. We can directly apply the formula A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N. A is 1331, P is 1000, 1 plus R by 100 to the power 3. Now 1331 upon 1000 is equal to 1 plus R by 100 to the power 3. Whenever such questions are asked, usually values given are known values. Now in this case, if you look at it closely, 1331 is 11 cube. Alright? And 1000 is 10 cube. So 11 cube upon 10 cube is equal to 1 plus R by 100 whole cube. So whole cube goes away and we get 11 by 10 equal to 1 plus R by 100. But yes, you can do this question only if you remember this, because otherwise it will be really difficult to solve. So R by 100 is equal to 11 by 10 minus 1, that is 1 by 10. From there, we have R by 100 equal to 1 by 10. So R is equal to 100 by 10, that is 10%. So the answer of this question is 10%. All right. But this question requires you to memorize the 11 cube is 1331. Just by looking at it, if you are able to use this particular thing, you'll be able to solve. Otherwise, it is going to be difficult. Okay. Now, let's take. But these questions are not asked for a very high, a very long period. The maximum is 3 years. Most of your questions will be related to 2 years, which is very easy. We'll look at all situations of 2 years. Okay. Now, let's take some more questions. Now, this question says an amount doubles in 5 years at compound interest. In how many years will it become 8 times? An amount doubles in 5 years at compound interest. How many years will it become 8 times? Right? Let's see. In compound interest, we have seen that the amounts are in the same ratio if taken at the same gap. Right? So P upon P1 is equal to P1 upon P2 is equal to P2 upon P3 and so on and so forth. This thing can be directly applied here. Here we are saying that suppose initial amount is P, after 5 years, let's say the amount is P5, and it's given that P5 is equal to 2P. So in fact, let me put it this way, it is 2P, after 5 years it is 2P, right? Now when the ratio is constant, what does it mean? The same, it is going to be multiplied by the same number. Here the ratio is 2 is to 1. Or we can also see that it is P multiplied by 2 is gets 2P. In simple interest, we used to work with the difference. This is compound interest. In this case, in the same duration, the ratio of two values is going to be constant. What does it mean? If from P to 2P that has taken 5 years, then in the next 5 years, what is going to happen? We can again multiply by 2. So 2P into 2, that will become 4P. So this is simpler than simple interest question. Again, after 5 years, what will happen? We can directly multiply by 2, so it becomes 8p. And I think this is where we have to reach. The question is asking how many years will it become? 8 times. So from p to 8p, if you calculate the total number of years is 5 plus 5 plus 5, which is 15 years. So this was a much simpler question. We are using this property, though it is much simpler than that also. If the amount is getting twice, or if it is getting multiplied by 2 in 5 years, then in every 5 years, it will keep on getting multiplied by 2. Why? Because if I say this is P, this is P5, this is P10, this is P15, then P upon P5 has to be P5 upon P10. Alright? It has to be P10 upon P15. It has to be P15 upon P20 and so on and so forth. Why? As long as we take the same gap, the ratio is going to be constant. Now, P upon P5, we already know it is given as 1 by 2. So, P5 upon P10 will also be 1 by 2. P10 upon P15 will also be 1 by 2. So, every 5 years, the amount will keep getting doubled. So, answer to this question is 15 years. You just had to check how many times does it take 5 years to complete or to get to 8 times the original value. Let's take another question on this. Now in this question it says an amount triples in 6 years compound interest. In how many years will it become 81 times, sorry. In how many years will it become 81 times, right? Now in this question, what do? Let's say P is the initial amount. After 6 years, it becomes 3P. That means it has become 3 times, right? Because it is tripling after 6 years, okay? Now, what we have learned here, in the same gap, it is going to be multiplied by the same number. So in 6 years, it is being multiplied by 3. So in the next 6 years, it is again going to be multiplied by 3 and this value multiplied by 3. So it becomes 3 threes are 9P. Again 6 years, it is again going to be multiplied by 3. So it becomes 27P. And again 6 years, it is going to be multiplied by 3. So 27 into 3 is 81P. So from P to 81P, it is 4 times 6 years, right? Please understand, it is a different thing. It is compound interest situation that we are doing now, all right? So it becomes 4 times 6 years, that is 24 years. So this will happen in 24 years, okay? So this is an easier situation. Compound interest case is an easier situation, all right? So this is one beautiful case that we have done, okay? Let's take a couple of more questions on the fundamental properties first.